or being misgendered. Try bridging the gap and going, hey, haven't you ever had times where you've been on the phone? Yeah. Haven't you had moments where someone used the wrong honorific and they said Mr. or Miss? Or they used the wrong pronoun? Or they called you Miss instead of Mrs. as you actually are? Yeah. And go, now picture that every day of your life. At every moment, at every turn, no matter how many times you correct others, no matter how many times you note it otherwise, people continue over and over to say Miss instead of Mrs. or Mrs. instead of Miss. Taking on an assumption of you purely based off of your appearance, behavior, speech, etc. Voice, tone, pitch, not caring or not endeavoring to take that to heart, memory, or make any attempt that you believe to be genuine, or making attempts that you doubt to be genuine. Wouldn't that be horrible? And they may go, oh, wow, that does make sense. Okay, I'm sorry. I get it. I really am sorry. Or they may go, I don't understand this whole issue with trans people and misgendering. And you can take a note from things I've seen in social media. It's something to the vein of, people have pets, be it cat, dog, bird, what have you, one sex or another. And if a stranger comes up to you with a dog, say a little dachshund, and they have a bow in their hair, and you say that, aw, that's a cute little girl, about their pet, and they just really liked that bow, or their dog just happened to sniff at that, and it was something that they saw in the store and figured, well, little puppy is, you know, sniffing at it, and it seems like it wants it, so why not? I'll get it for it. It's my pet. It's my family, you know? But it's actually a boy dog. So, what do most pet owners do? Oh, it's a he. And everyone goes, oh, yes, you're a good boy, you're a good boy, yeah. Yeah, you like your bow, don't you? And they'll never, ever question, doubt, or make an attempt to lift it up by the back of its tail and question whether or not the owner was right, or even go against the owner, or even possibly repeat their error ever again. So why does misgendering happen to people and not always get corrected? Even by those meaning well, even by those trying visibly, notably, discernibly, evidentially, provably, factually, trying their hardest. Why does it happen even then to people? And it's to be brushed under and treated as, I'm doing my best. I really don't mean it. I'm sorry. You're just going to have to work with me. I'm getting used to things. Okay, that's fine. But why do you have no problem giving it to a pet owner? Correcting, learning, noting, remembering. When I'm your family, I'm your friend. I'm your aunt. I'm your cousin. I'm your neighbor. I'm your coworker. Maybe your manager. Maybe I'm some governor, what have you. Why does it matter? Why is it so huge of an issue between those two? Why is it such a huge divide? Use that as a way. Use a more personalized route. And people will understand a little easier. I think, maybe they'll go, oh, wow, I get it. I'm sorry. Maybe. Possibly not, but maybe so. Understand that if you're going to make a way for people to use a vocabulary to better understand you and those you share commonalities with, that it needs to be personalized. It needs pertain to them and their life. And they need to understand why it is that it matters to them. And they also need to find ways to equate it with things in their life. And it will become normative. It will become their new reality. It doesn't mean that it wasn't real before, but it will be real to them more because now they understand it easier because it is pertinent to their life and things in their life and people.